Welcome to PAC TV. I'm Jet.
And I'm Carter. And today is Wednesday, October 13th. And it's National M&M Day. I love the green ones.
And I love the red ones. Anyway, Sadie Hawkins is less than 3 weeks, and the theme is deer hunt. Hopefully you've got your date, ladies.
And let's start today with something really fun, a candy bar giveaway, sponsored by the Silver Dollar. See if you can watch and answer this, you League of Legends fans.
If you know the answer, please come down to Smith's room right now. Now to update us on the current news of the world, here's News Stuff.
Welcome to News Stuff, where we talk about stuff in the news. Utah reaches new COVID death milestone at 3,000.
Salt Lake City schools mask mandate has been extended through Christmas break. The CDC decided to go this way due to an influx of COVID cases in the Salt Lake Valley.
William Shatner will be the oldest man blasted to space at 90. Jeff Bezos decided to take him along for the ride.
A small plane crashed into a San Diego suburb, killing two. One was a FedEx driver, the other was a regular civilian just enjoying a stroll.
Hurricane Pamela is a near-major hurricane that's about to hit Mexico near Baja, California. If you're planning on going there, we would advise otherwise.
Fish and Game are investigating the death of a bald eagle in eastern Idaho. They believe the eagle was killed out of spite for the nation, or maybe it was for survival. We don't know.
Police are still looking for the notorious Dr. Swain after he fled the scene of a botched surgery for which he was not qualified to perform. If you have any information, please contact the authorities. He's a dangerous man, and he will stop at nothing to see your feet. Scrumptious.
Now in sports, John Gruden is resigning as Raiders head coach after racist and homophobic emails were exposed to the New York Times. Got him.
Thank you for tuning in. This has been New Stuff with PAC TV. I'm Mr. Smith.
And I'm Rex.
Thanks for watching.
Wow. Many of the departments are now accepting applications to become a Sterling Scholar. If you don't know how or want to apply, these applications are due on November 1st to become a Sterling Scholar, and it will look good on any application or job application.
And NHS is hosting a Socktober drive. Here's more on this.
The National Honor Society is hosting a Socktober drive. Bring any socks to the Counseling Center or the library. Donations are due October 22nd.
Speaking of NHS, they still have a treasure hunt going on, and remember, it's a race. There are multiple teams working on the final clue. Just remember, the final prize will disappear on Halloween, so hurry and find the final QR code. And NHS is still accepting new members, so if you have the grades, then become a member.
And the FFA alumni is also conducting a fundraiser. If anyone has any clothes to donate, please put it in a sack and take it to one of the FFA advisors or classrooms.
And FCCLA wants to thank those who stopped by their table at lunch. Riley Taylor was the winner of this guessing jar. She picked the correct answer on how many candy bars were in this jar. Great job, Riley, and you can come pick this up from Mrs. Roundy's room in B115.
Any students interested in attending the DECA and Utah State event on October 25th need to see Mr. Pollard today to sign up.
Now let's go to Connor in the locker room with sports, which is sponsored by the Silver Dollar.
What's up, Wolves? It's sports! Brought to you by the Silver Dollar. Tonight is the big rivalry football game at Weber tonight. The theme is Hick Night. So wear what you have on and also bring your awesome puffy vest, because it's going to be cold. Yesterday, the girls' soccer team played a very good Riverton team in second round of the playoffs and lost 4-1. Olivia Van Orden got the only goal for the Lady Wolves. Great season, ladies. Last night, the volleyball team had a great turnout and great support for their fundraiser game, and they ended the evening with a 3-0 sweep over Weber. They played next Tuesday at Syracuse. Remember, if you want food and other swag, you'll find it in the Silver Dollar. That's it for sports. Back to you two.
Thanks. Thanks, Connor. Hey, students and teachers, if you want to enter a pumpkin in Plain City's first ever pumpkin walk, just drop off your painted or carved pumpkin at Lee Olson Park on Thursday the 1st. This would be a great project for a club or team to participate. Hint, hint.
Now here's Dr. Swain with Med Talk.
Welcome to Med Talk. I'm Dr. Carson Swain. It's almost fall break, so you know what that means. Lots of fall. On average, a person in a retirement home will have 2 to 3 falls per year. And most male high schoolers will fall on average once a week for a girl they'll never be able to get with. Thanks for coming to my Med Talk.
Hey, Wolves, it's me, Dr. Carson.
Hey, everybody, fall break's tomorrow, so we're going to...
And at 3 p.m. today, fall break will be made official. Let's see what others are doing during fall break.
Hey, everybody, fall break's tomorrow, so we're going to go around and ask a couple of our fellow Fremont students what they're going to be up to. Excuse me. Wait. Hold up. Can you tell me what you're doing for fall break?
Nothing, just going home and homework, probably. Lots of that.
Fascinating. Excuse me, sir. What are you doing for fall break?
I'm just out here going to Las Vegas. I really got to get to my Pack to Be class, though, so my teacher doesn't mark me late. I mean, absent.
Better get going. Excuse me. Can you guys tell me what you're doing for fall break?
I'm going camping up in the Flaming Gorge. Hopefully it's not snowing, though, because weather's been pretty bad.
I'm just going to my house, you know, going home, maybe sleeping.
Chilling?
Yeah.
I'm going to see a play for an assignment.
Fun? For school?
Yes.
What play?
It's Spamalot.
What are you doing for fall break?
I'm going camping with my family.
Have fun.
And now let's go to Colton to see who today's candy bar giveaway winner is.
And we are here with today's candy bar winner, Aiden Moore. Today's question was, which League of Legends champion is the strongest? And what's the answer, Aiden?
It's Arlai and Sol, basically God.
That is correct. So today, you win a pack of M&Ms for National M&M Day. Is there anyone you want to give a shout out to?
Xander Murphy, because he is blonde and he got nominated for Student of the Month.
Nice, that's awesome. And also the winner of our microwave, signed microwave by Carson Swain, was Gavin Hill. So Gavin Hill, come get a microwave.
Thanks, you're probably not watching anymore, but we still hope you have a magnificent Wednesday, Wolves.